Hi Arif, congratulations on getting ranked 74 this year in 2016. Tell us something about yourself.
Thank you very much. Myself Arif Ahsan, and I am from Gaya district, Bihar state. And I have completed this 6 years UPSC examination and I've got 74 rank. Since doing my graduation, I always wanted to be civil servant, and for this I prepared for a long time, and at last I got selected in this year.
Tell us something about your family and education background.
My family comes from a very humble background, and my mother is a housemaker and my father is a retired high school teacher. And he has always given me the values which he has, which was very much dear to him. And because of his values and teachings, what I am today because of him only. And I have, we are 6 siblings, and I am second last. And all our elders are married now. And that's it.
When did you choose to become a civil servant, and why?
Actually, becoming a civil servant, it was in my mind since my graduation only. And for this, my father and my friend has always motivated to become a civil servant. Actually, it got into mind when I started doing job in the private sector. I thought a civil servant can do a much better thing and can bring changes in the life of the common people in a better way. So I decided to become a civil servant then and thereafter. And so I quit the job, and since then I'm preparing for civil service.
So how did it feel to crack this exam in your 6th attempt?
It was satisfying and also very happy for me, moment for me, because you know, it was a long journey and also very hectic. So in this there was a role of my hard work and also perseverance. And in this, unless until your parents and friends are not motivating you and very supporting in this long journey, I think it would have been very difficult for me. And since I have done or got selected in this, so it is like that I have got my dream fulfilled. So it's like feeling like that only.
What was your driving force? Because it's a long journey.
Driving force was my father. Be frank, I'm accepting this fact. Because he has always seen something for the public's well-being. I have seen that being a school teacher also, he has always done good to the common people. Because we are in the Gaya district, so it was a center point for all the people who were coming from the villages. And my father belonged to Aurangabad district, Bihar. So it was like for health or any journey, everyone used to stop there. So in spite of very limited resources, my father used to cater to them. So I thought if I would become a civil servant, I can do much better for serving the common people. And he has always seen me in that angle only. And he has told me that do those things which can be helpful for others only. So I chose to become a civil servant from that there only. And in this process, he never doubted me. That this thing was the most important thing for this. In this long journey.
So, what will be your priorities after coming into services?
It depends upon the places where I'll be posted, because you know, there's a cadre allocation in this service. So, most probably, I will be getting my first preference Bihar or UP. But if you go through the problems of Bihar and UP, and particularly in Bihar, because in Bihar, you know, there's always bad news because of education and health. I think education is the most important thing where a civil servant, and in particular me, I will be doing better job, because my father is also from education background and from teaching background. So you may be in daily newspaper, you may be hearing that there is an incidence of cheating and failure of students, number of students getting the first rank is very low. And at the same time, you also hear that a large number of students are cracking the civil services. Mm-hmm. And I also from that institute only. So there is a mismatch between the elementary level and the higher education. So we have to increase the enrollment level at the elementary level. And there, how to translate or translate those elementary at the higher level. So that is the important thing. And second is the quality of education. And for this, I think there is absence of training institute there, teachers training absent, and also the accountability from the part of the teachers is also lacking, because there are a number of incidences where dummy teacher concept is there in Bihar. So these things should be stopped. I think then we can have a better education system in Bihar. And second important thing is the health. Because unless the body is not healthy, I think you cannot do anything. And also in Bihar, indicators of many human development indexes is very low. So at these two fronts are important priority area for me when I'll be there, posted there in Gaya or in Bihar.
That's a perfect service as an answer. Tell us something about your hobbies and interests.
Initially, I was very much interested in cricket, and I also used to play chess. And but because of the, during preparation, I got very lesser chance time for the cricket. But I used to play chess online also with the friends on also. Apart from this, I like to watch movies and to listen song only.
Which was the last movie you watched?
Last movie I watched is Aligarh.
Okay. So how much time do you think one needs for this preparation, ideally?
See, this is very common question. But one thing I would like to tell that time quantity is required, but I think quality is more important. Because time, if you are studying 15 hours or 16 hours, but you are not able to concentrate on the topics, then I think it is of no use. If you are studying 10 hours and you have very much very good focus on the topics, I think that is a very good thing. So in this examination, quality is very important, and also how much you are giving the setup. You know, if someone is starting this process, this examination process, I think he should make first schedule of a whole day and follow it repeatedly. It may be appears mechanical, but see, this exam is very vast and time taking. So unless and until you are not going through the same things again and again, you will not be able to internalize the things. So you will not be able to produce another paper. So it may appears mechanical sometimes, but there are other avenues also where you can be free your mind, like jogging or running or watching movies, anything you can do. But when your study time is there, forget about everything and concentrate on the topics which you are studying. So if you are giving 10 to 12 hours daily on a yearly basis, I think you will get through, or anyone who is preparing for this exam will get through the process.
So do you think the exam is more analysis oriented than fact oriented?
This is a very relevant question. I think this is a mix of both. See, many questions are which are current oriented questions in mains specifically. So if you are answering those questions, you have to answer mix of both fact and analysis. Because if you are backing any question, suppose you are writing center-state relation of any state or any party in general, so you have to give the reference of the articles in which area there is a mains relation between center-state, and you have also to analyze with the current situation in which state what is going on, and there is a violation of this article. So there is analysis also, and also the fact part also. But it should not be like that, you are just mugging up the things. Article, you are just mugging up the article. Unless you are not making it analytically, then it will be very much problematic for you in the future, in the examination also.
So you are saying to adapt a mixed approach?
Mixed approach, yes.
Is coaching totally indispensable for this preparation?
I think not indispensable, but I think if you have good guidance, if you have, you have talked to someone who has qualified for this examination, or there are many institutes which are running for this particular purpose only without any commercial purposes, I think that is important. Because in this examination you have to identify what not to read and what to read. Because syllabus is very huge, unless until you are not separating those things, you will be just reading the things and you are not able to internalize things. So for this, you have to be very specific to the syllabus, and for this guidance is important. So if you are joining any particular coaching institute, I think there is no bad thing in that. I have not joined anything, I am not advocating to joining it. But the thing is, if someone is coming from somewhere else and he is not knowing anything about this examination, he has to well aware of the whole process so that he can sit and start preparing for this. For this, he can take guidance from anywhere.
How important is internet while preparing for UPSC?
At
Did
this,
you use internet.
Yeah, at this stage, I think this is the most important thing. Internet is the most important because everything is available on internet. See, knowledge textbook can give you a very limited knowledge. जहाँ पे आपको एक पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक के बारे में कुछ ही चीज़ें मालूम होगी, बट इंटरनेट क्या करेगा कि वट एवर द थिंग्स विच आर बियॉन्ड दोज टेक्स्ट बुक एंड द करेंट थिंग, जिसको आपको एसिमिलेट करना है आपको आंसर्स में, तो आप उसको इंटरनेट से ही कर सकते हैं. इट्स लाइक ए एनी टॉपिक और इफ यू आर सिटिंग एनी वेयर एट द फ्री टाइम और एट द मूव ऑन द गो, यू कैन पिक अप द फोन एंड यू कैन सर्च और सी द टॉपिक. तो उससे क्या होता है कि आप रिवाइज भी कर लेते हैं टॉपिक से, यू आर नोइंग न्यू थिंग्स वेरी इजली. सो मुझे लगता है कोई भी बच्चा अगर तैयारी कर रहा है इस एग्ज़ाम की, तो सबसे पहला काम करे कोई इंटरनेट कनेक्शन ले, एक लैपटॉप इंटरनेट कनेक्शन और ए गुड फोन, ए स्मार्टफोन, बट फॉर द स्टडी पर्पज ओनली, बिकॉज देर आर मेनी थिंग्स आर गोइंग ऑन हेयर मीन्स राइट नाउ, उससे दूर रहें. बट पढ़ाई के लिए आपको इंटरनेट बहुत ज़रूरी है.
Mindset should candidates keep by preparing for this exam?
See, this exam ka sabse important part hai what you want to do, what you want to achieve from your life. See, process is long, many process students come and go, they think that yahan nahi ho raha kahin aur try kar lete hain, theek hai, but that is also good because bahut sare situations ho sakte hain, financial ho sakte hain ya fir time factor ho sakta hai ki utna time hone ke baad bhi अब लगता है कि नहीं होगा या बाद में करूँगा, तो आप चॉइसेस ले सकते हैं. मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हैव क्वालिफाइड आफ्टर डूइंग जॉब, तो देर आर ऑप्शन अवेलेबल फॉर यू, बट द माइंड सेट इज दैट वॉट यू वॉन्ट. इफ यू वॉन्ट IAS देन यू हैव टू बी फोकस ऑन इट इवन आफ्टर यू ज्वाइनिंग द सर्विसेज और एनी अदर जॉब. इफ यू आर लूजिंग दैट थिंग, आई थिंक यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू बिकम IAS. दिस इज वेरी क्लियर. सो द माइंड सेट शुड बी दैट आई हैव कम हेयर और वॉट एवर द मोटिवेशन फैक्टर और वॉट एवर ड्राइव मी टू दिस डिसीजन आई हैव टू अपहोल्ड इट दिस. ये माइंड सेट होनी चाहिए अगर आपको तैयारी करनी है तो. अगर आप जॉब भी ज्वाइन कर लेते हैं, हो सकता है बहुत सारे अपनी फाइनेंशियल कंस्ट्रेंट्स होती हैं या अदर कंस्ट्रेंट्स होते हैं जैसे ज्वाइन करें, उसमें कोई बुराई नहीं है, मैंने स्टूडेंट क्वालिफाइड, बट यू हैव टू बी फोकस, मुझे करनी है.